Welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss the design of DFA for few additional problems. Let's start the session. Suppose we want to design a DFA. The language consists of all strings over 0 and 1 such that number of 1s are divisible by 4. So sigma is 0 and 1. We need to count number of 1s. So number of 1s must be a multiple of 4. So it can be 4 ones, 8 and so on. So initially suppose we have a state q 0. On reading of 1, we will move to another state q 1. On reading of second 1, we will move to another state q 2. On reading of third 1, we will move to state q 3. And reading of fourth 1, we will come back to q 0 state. And let's call q 0 is our final state. We will not take care of any number of 0. So any number of 0 can occur on q0, q1, q2 and q3. Its corresponding regular expression will be, we will fix number of 1 as 4 and any number of 0 can occur in between these 1s and after this 1. So it can repeat any number of time, plus we can say 0 star if number of 1 is 0. It will also be divisible by 4. Now suppose we want to design a DFA over A, B and C such that every string in L contains a substring triple C. So first we will design a DFA that will accept triple C, and once triple C will occur, there can be any number of A, B and C. Before first C, any number of A and B can occur. Let's call it as Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. Q3 denotes that triple C has already occurred. Q2 indicates double C has occurred and we are waiting for another C. Q1 indicates that C has occurred and we are waiting for 2C to reach into the final state. But if we will read A or B on Q1, it will break our patterns and we will start searching again. So if we will read A or B on Q1, we will come back to Q0 state. Similarly, if we will read A or B on Q2, we will come back to Q0 state. Now we want to design a DFA for the language L, which will accept all string W such that length of W mod 5 equal to 0 and W is any string over A and B. What it means, length of W if divided by 5 will give us remainder 0, means length of W must be a multiple of 5 and so on. So we will design a DFA with the initial state as Q0. If we will read first symbol as A or B, we will move to another state. Then we will read the second symbol A or B, we will move to Q2. Then we will read the third symbol A or B, we will move to Q3 state. Then we will read the fourth symbol A or B, we will move to Q4 state. Whenever we are reading the fifth symbol, we will come back to Q0 state. And this process will be repeated and we can able to accept all string whose length is a multiple of 5. Now Q0 will become the final state. Now we want to design a DFA for the language L that consists of all string over A, B and C. So sigma is A, B and C such that it will consist of all string consisting of at least one A and at least one B. So our minimum condition for the acceptance of string is minimum 1a and minimum 1b must be appear. So let's suppose first symbol is a or first symbol will be b. So from q0 state we will move to q1 on reading of first a. On reading of b we will move to q2. So q1 is satisfying the minimum condition of a, and if another b will occur, we will reach into the final state. Let's call it as q3. Similarly, Q2 is satisfying the condition of minimum 1B, and if we will read 1A over there, we will reach into the final state, and after that any number of A, B or C can occur. So Q3 will become the final state. Now Q1 is satisfying the condition of minimum 1A. So if any number of A will occur, we will remain in Q1. Similarly, if C will occur, we will remain in Q1. If we will read any number of B on Q2 or any number of C on Q2, we will remain in Q2, and we are expecting to read A and we will move into the final state. If we will read any number of C in Q0, we will remain in Q0 state. Now we want to design a DFA for the language that consists of all string of even length over A and B. So we can able to define a string is of either odd length or even length. We have two states. One is the state we will indicate of even symbols, and another one is of odd symbol. So if the first symbol is either A or B, we will move to the odd number of symbol state, and if we will read again A or B, we will come back to even number of states. It will become our final state. Now suppose we want to design a DFA for L is ANBM, where N comma M is greater than equal to 1, and another DFA we want to design for ANBM, where N and M is greater than equal to 0. So first we will design DFA for this one. So minimum A will occur, and after that any number of A can occur, then B will appear, then after that any number of B can come. So we can design it by the DFA. Q0 is our initial state. On reading of A, we will move to Q1 state, then any number of A can occur. On reading of first B, we will move into the final state, and after that any number of B can occur. Let's call Q2 as the final state. Now we will design the DFA for ANBM, where N and M is greater than equal to 0. So it can be represented by A star B star. Null will be the accepted string. So Q0 will become the final state. Any number of A can occur on this one. Then on reading of B, we will move to another state. Let's call it as Q1, and it will also be the final state. And after that, any number of B can occur. Thanks for watching this session.